Hi everyone. In today's video, I'm going to talk about this lovely plant. This is the Albuca spiralis. It is also called the corkscrew plant, or it's called the frizzle sizzle. And the reason for calling it Albuca spiralis or frizzle sizzle is these beautiful leaves that kind of turn right like a corkscrew. This plant is a native to South Africa. It's quite drought tolerant. And the reason why I wanted to show you this plant now is because I've had this in my collection for the last 3 years, and this is the first time I'm seeing it bloom. Okay, so it's got these lovely yellow flowers that are blooming, and the best part of it is these flowers that look down. They're called nodding flowers, very trumpety shape, but not upright looking up, but looking down. So with their nodding shape and lovely fragrance, so they are, reminds me of opening a vanilla box or essence. When you open the vanilla essence bottle, the kind of fragrance that you get, a very similar fragrance, not very overpowering, but at the same time very sweet scent that these flowers have. And I'm looking forward, there are multiple buds on this. So if you see this one, there's a big bunch of buds here, similarly here. And I'm seeing a bunch of buds developing here as well. So when I purchased this from a seller on Facebook almost 3 years back, as I said, and I got these two very little bulbs, tiny bulbs that came, and then I just potted them and I started to read up about the plant care. Right, so this plant, given that it is from South Africa, it is used to going through the dry cycle, as well as it doesn't like too much watering. So it's the same condition that you need to give it. First of all, put it in very loose, succulent like soil, which is well draining, and then put it in the brightest spot in your balcony. So it is not a plant for indoors or for shade, etc. You need to give it enough bright light, not direct sunlight, because if you give it direct sunlight, one of the problems is the tips can get brown, and that's one balance that I have been trying to maintain. While it loves the bright light, it doesn't like the direct sun. So keeping it in a very bright area, but at the same time protecting it from harsh sun, is what you need to be looking for. And watering it very rarely. If you see my soil, it is almost very dry, and that's how you want to keep it. You don't want this to be soaking wet. And once in a while, maybe I do it like once a month or so, I water it deeply and then let it dry, and then I don't worry about the plant for another month or so. And that's really what my care tip has been with this plant. So the bulb is quite sensitive, so if the water gets into the bulb, it can rot. So ensuring that minimal watering and then drying thoroughly between watering is what you need to keep in mind. Now the other thing, an interesting fact about this plant is, unlike most plants which grow during the summer season and go dormant in winter, I see more growth on this plant in winter, and it actually goes dormant in summer. So in the wild, what happens is during the summer, all these leaves disappear and it goes down to the bulb. So, and then once it starts raining, new leaves develop and the cycle continues. But as a house plant, you can avoid this dormancy cycle by also watering it in winter, right? Rather than keeping it completely dry, if you keep watering it consistently, but at the same time, when I say consistently, once a month, not every week or so, right? Very rarely you need to water it, but keep watering it through the season so that this foliage continues. So this Albuca, what you're growing this is for this lovely foliage and this beautiful corkscrew design, right? One thing I've noticed with mine is some of them grow straight, some of them have these topsy-turvy, especially the new leaves that I see are getting that corkscrew design. And more I put it in sun, more the pattern of this corkscrew comes up. So this is just an observation. I don't know if it's supposed to behave that way. But all in all, this is a lovely little plant that gives you a lot of joy. It looks so delicate with these very narrow leaves. And this wacky name, the Frizzle Sizzle, that's a selling point for sure. Apart from that, the low maintenance. You put it in bright light and then water it so rarely and the plant will survive. I haven't seen any pests, to be honest. Not a single mealybug or an aphid or any attack on this. It just grows and grows, and it throws these lovely beautiful leaves, as well as now as an added bonus these lovely flowers as well. So nothing to complain really about the plant. Not very easy to find it. Obviously, this is one of those exotic plants that you will find with the sellers who normally sell exotic plants. So you'll have to be on a lookout for these on Facebook or Instagram, on sellers who specialize in exotic plants. But if you do get one, find a seller, please find one, because this is one of those lovely plants that you can add to your collection. Okay, so genus is Albuca. It's from the same family as asparagus. So easy plant to grow. So thanks so much for watching, and I hope you like this video. Bye.